Hello everyone, in this video let us take a look at the question that was asked recently about removing story points from bug. Now this question was asked on the community, and this question is basically all about having issues in a board, on a Scrum board. And if you read the question, this question is a bit interesting. So this user is showing us a board, or maybe a backlog view of two bugs coming from maybe different projects in a single Scrum board, but he is not sure why only one of the issue type, which is of course bug, but why only the issue type from a specific project has this field called story points. Why not the other one? So basically he wants to remove the story point from the first issue type as well. Now I thought I'll probably record a video by showing you how it can be done, and I think I know the answer. So if you take a look at this board, this board has issues coming from two different projects. Now in both of my projects I have this issue type called bug, but if you look at the backlog view here, I'll probably move them a bit on top so that you can take a look at it easily. So basically I have these two bugs, but only one of the issue type of type bug has the field on the right hand side called story point. So if you look at this bug, which is bug one, I have this story point field, which I can of course modify if I click on the issue, and on the right hand side this field is there for me to change. But I don't really have this field in my other issue, which is again a bug, but since it is coming from a different project, the most common thing or the problem could be adding this field in the screen used in that other project in the right issue type screen. So basically you can add this field in the screen, but the problem is not really just with the screens. If you're using your Scrum boards, especially on cloud, you can actually have this field enabled, this story point field enabled, with the help of the context. So let us do one thing. Let us also add this story point field in the other bug as well, which is actually coming from a different project. Now, if I go to my Jira settings, I can then go to issues. So I'm Jira administrator, so I can modify the context of custom fields. On the left hand side, if I go to my custom fields, then I can search for a field called as story points. And if I go to the configure option of my story point, I will be able to modify the context. So right now this particular field only has one context called default configuration scheme for story points. And if I click on this edit configuration link, I can of course take a look at different issue types where this field is available. So right now this field is available for story and bug. So this is of course that you need to do when you are trying to use a field. The field might be there on the screen, but if there is no context for it defined in the configuration of the field, you won't be able to use it. The other thing that you can do and you should do is also take a look at the applicable context for the project. So right now this particular field is only available for my Scrum project, Scrum with capital letters. I can also enable my other project called Scrum project. So in my particular board, I have this bug coming from this bug issue type coming from these two different projects. So if I click on the modify, I have now modified the context of the bug to include both the projects. So if I go back to my configuration or my board, I can do a refresh, and hopefully the field should be there in both the projects. So let us take a look at the situation now. So right now we have the bug one, which is coming, I believe, from my Scrum project, but my first bug is coming from my Scrum project, which is the name of my project. But the thing here is that you can do now is modify the story point. So now we have the option to modify the story point for both the bugs in the same board. So this is something that you should be looking at, apart from making sure that you have the context set on the issue type. Also take a look at the applicable context on the project. So this is all I wanted to share in this video. I hope you enjoyed and you learned something new today. Thank you very much.